Remember a year ago when Republicans insisted that the newly impeached Donald Trump had learned his lesson? Welcome to Unfiltered from Home. I'm SE Cupp. Yes, I'm certain I remember Republican senators saying not to worry. Trump was chastened by his impeachment over the Ukraine phone calls in which Trump encouraged the president there to investigate his political rival to come up with some dirt, as it were. He'd never do anything like that again. Remember that? Republicans voted to acquit Trump of the charges against him because they said he won't do it again. Senator Mike Braun of Indiana, remember, assured, "I think he'll put two and two together." In this case, he was taken to the carpet. Senator Lamar Alexander of Tennessee said, "Yeah, I think he would think twice before he did it again." And of course, Maine's own Senator Susan Collins gave the definitive, "you will live to regret this" hot take, saying, "I believe that the president has learned from this case. The president has been impeached. That's a pretty big lesson." For anyone else, maybe, sure, lesson learned. Getting impeached, after all, is a pretty resounding rebuke of your behavior. And for most people, super embarrassing. But for Trump, who is incapable of shame, the quote-unquote lesson he learned from his impeachment wasn't to stop doing impeachable things. It was to keep doing impeachable things because essentially he got away with it. Remember, Republicans defended him, protected him during the trials, and ultimately acquitted him, which, unsurprisingly, emboldened him. Cut to right now. A tape released by the Washington Post has Trump coercing the Georgia Secretary of State to find 11,780 votes, votes that don't exist, so that he can claim an election victory. In the call, which I encourage you to listen to in full, Trump is heard pressing Brad Raffensperger to provide fraud evidence that doesn't exist, to agree with his baseless conspiracy theories. Trump berates the Secretary of State and threatens him and his attorney with possible criminal implications if they don't comply, to all of which the Georgia officials resisted admirably and decisively. The call is, in a word, disgraceful. Trump's attempt to steal the election in the way he's accused Democrats of doing is brazen. It's clear as night and day. There's no way around it. Trump tried to conspire to rig a free and fair Democratic election in America. Few Republicans have come out to condemn that, and don't hold your breath. Their indifference to Trump's unethical, illegal, undemocratic behavior, well, it's gotten them this far. Why stop now? Republicans are, of course, complicit in aiding and abetting Trump's naked power grabs. If they'd been rebuking him all along, who knows? It's possible he would have learned the lesson that he can't get away with it. Then again, some people never learn. Pathological narcissists, for example, often believe they are untouchable, impervious to consequences. I'm reminded of folks like Anthony Weiner, who first denied he'd been sending pictures of his package to other women who weren't his wife, and then admitted he was. After suffering the humiliation of that scandal and resigning from Congress over it, well, he was caught doing it again while running for New York City mayor with a documentary film crew following him around. That is some serious narcissism. People like that don't learn lessons. They'll keep believing they were the victims, and they'll find ways to justify their bad actions and try over and over and over again to keep getting away with it. Bill Cosby, Bernie Madoff, Jeffrey Epstein, Harvey Weinstein, powerful men who flaunted their bad behavior in broad daylight and dodged accountability for so long. Or Donald Trump, who liked to brag that if you're a celebrity, you can get away with anything. The commonality is a belief that justice will never find you. In the case of the president, though, we have mechanisms to help ensure that it does. Mechanisms like oversight, separation of powers, and yes, Congress, which is supposed to make sure the president, even if he's from your own party, upholds the Constitution and follows the laws. This Republican Congress failed to do that basic job. They let Trump break the rules, skirt the laws, avoid accountability, and evade justice over and over again. And they'll do it again this week with at least 12 Republican senators vowing to challenge Wednesday's Electoral College vote in a meaningless stunt that just helps reaffirm Trump's delusional narcissism. Now, we didn't need any proof that Trump wasn't chastened by impeachment. That was clear to anyone with a pulse. So really, all that the Georgia call did was reveal that Trump did learn an invaluable lesson. That the spineless, cowardly, and corrupted Republicans in Congress would not stand in the way of his criming. In fact, they'd help. Okay, that does it for me. See you next week.